وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
I'm going to conclude inshallah ta'ala with how the sins, brothers, when it occurs from you, it takes away the blessings. Brothers, al-ma'asi sababun li zawali ni'am. Memorize that. The sins are the reasons why blessings go. The good and the blessings that you had will go. It won't remain for you anymore. Let's mention some of the evidence. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said to the companions, وَمَا أَصَابَكُم مِّن مُصِيبَةٍ. The things that you were afflicted with and the harm that touched you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, وَمَا أَصَابَكُم. It didn't afflict you, these harm and these pain and these problems did not afflict you, except through what reason? إِلَّا بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ مِن مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ وَيَعْفُ عَنْ كَثِيرٌ. It only came to you because of that which your hands put forward. Pay attention. Allah is clearly telling us, وَمَا أَصَابَكُمْ مِن مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ. And look what Allah said after that. وَيَعْفُ عَنْ كَثِيرٌ. And He actually forgave us for a lot. Because if everything we did, He took away the blessings from us, we wouldn't even live. He only is punishing us for some of the sins that we did. Are we all together, brothers? Sins will take away blessings from you. Because brothers, if Allah sends a punishment on us, there's one of two ways that we can answer this. We can either say Allah is oppressing us, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is His oppression. Subhanallah, ma'adallah. Can we say that about Allah? And the second one is that we blame ourselves. And we say this is what we've done to ourselves. Allah says in another ayah, فَأَكْثَرُوا فِيهَا الْفَسَادِ فَصَبَّ عَلَيْهِمْ رَبُّكَ سَوْطَ عَذَابٍ. فَأَكْثَرُوا فِيهَا الْفَسَادِ. They increased in the corruption that they brought to this earth. And then look what Allah then says, فَصَبَّ عَلَيْهِمْ رَبُّكَ سَوْطَ عَذَابٍ. And then Allah sent to them a severe punishment. The punishment, when did it come? فَأَكْثَرُوا فِيهَا الْفَسَادِ. When they increased in the corruption that they were causing, then the punishment came. Then the punishment came. Allah says in another ayah, وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْقُرَىٰ آمَنُوا. If the people of the village were to believe, وَاتَّقَوْا, and they were to come with taqwa, لَفَتَحْنَا, we would have opened for them, عَلَيْهِمْ بَرَكَاتٍ مِّنَ السَّمَاءِ, we would have opened for them the blessings of the sky, وَالْأَرْضِ, the blessing from the sky is that we would have sent rain, and we would have sent وَالْأَرْضِ, from this earth, we would have brought crops from them, from the earth, وَلَكِنْ, but we're not going to do neither of those for them. Why? وَلَكِنْ كَذَّبُوا, they disbelieved. فَأَخَذْنَاهُمْ, Allah says, we grabbed them, subhanahu wa ta'ala, بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ, because of that which they did. Look what we said. وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْقُرَىٰ آمَنُوا وَاتَّقَوْا لَفَتَحْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ بَرَكَاتٍ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَلَكِنْ كَذَّبُوا فَأَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. It's simple. All that was needed from was iman and taqwa. What did Allah then say? I would have sent on them from the sky barakat, barakat, blessings. Why does Allah say I'll send from the sky barakat? Because some of the rains, brothers, it can destroy. Some of the rain, it can destroy. What destroyed the people of Nuh? Was it not rain that was sent down? Are we all together, brothers? The people of Ad, even what destroyed them? فَلَمَّا رَأُوهُ عَارِضًا مُسْتَقْبِلَ أَوْدِيَتِهِمْ قَالُوا هَذَا عَارِضٌ مُمْطِرُنَا بَلْ هُوَ مَسْتَعْجَلْتُمْ بِهِ رِيحٌ فِيهَا عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ تُدَمِّرُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ بِأَمْرِ رَبِّهَا فَأَصْبَحُوا لَا يُرَى إِلَّا مَسَاكِنُهُمْ. Pay attention. The rain that comes down can sometimes be a punishment for Allah, from Allah. وَلِذَلِكَ the messenger, whenever it rained or the sky became dark, دَخَلَ وَخَرَجْ, he would enter the room and he would come out and he would enter and you could be seen on his face. And then the Sahaba, they said, Ya Rasulullah, it's a rain, it's bringing blessings for us. And then the Prophet said, فَلَمَّا رَأُوهُ عَارِضًا مُسْتَقْبِلَ أَوْدِيَتِهِمْ قَالُوا هَذَا عَارِضٌ مُمْطِرُنَا. That's what the people of Ad said. When they saw this cloud coming together and it becoming dark, the people of Ad, they didn't know it was the day that they were being punished. They said, ah, it's going to be a nice rain. But it was actually the day that the wind was coming. It was how it was formatting and how things were happening, brothers. Allah also said in another ayah, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those of you who believe, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ تَوَلَّوْا مِنْكُمْ يَوْمَ الْتَقَى الْجَمْعَانِ, those of you who turned away when the two armies met one another. This is the battle of Uhud. Those of you who turned away, because that day some of the companions, they ran away from the Prophet ﷺ. Are you with me, brothers? And our messenger was one of the bravest people when it came to battle. Nabiullah Muhammad never turned his back in a battlefield. Sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He never turned his back. Rather, when the Sahabas, they ran away from him, in the middle of the battle, he stood up, he said, I am the Prophet of Allah. Ana an-Nabi, la kadhib. Ana ibn Abd al-Muttalib. Imagine, in the middle of the battlefield, the overwhelming majority of your soldiers and your army ran away from you. The enemy is willing to kill you, and you shout your name out and you tell them, I'm the Prophet of Allah. The only one who could do that is a brave and a courageous individual. Sah. He was very brave, salawatullahi wa salam alayhi. So he's calling his companions to come back. But he's saying his name out. He's saying who he is. He's not scared, sallallahu alayhi wa salam. So Allah says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ تَوَلَّوْا مِنْكُمْ يَوْمَ الْتَقَى الْجَمْعَانِ, those of you who turned their backs when the two armies met one another, إِنَّمَا اسْتَزَلَّهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ, shaytan made them slip. إِنَّمَا اسْتَزَلَّهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ, shaytan made them slip. Why? بِبَعْضِمَا كَسَبُوا, because of some of the sins and the mistakes that they came with. The reason why shaytan succeeded in getting to them is because of the mistakes that they did. In another ayah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala tells us a story, brothers. Allah tells us a story. He says, وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا قَرْيَةً كَانَتْ آمِنَةً مُطْمَئِنَّةً يَأْتِيهَا رِزْقُهَا رَغَدًا مِنْ كُلِّ مَكَانٍ فَكَفَرَتْ بِأَنْعُمِ اللَّهِ فَأَذَاقَهَا اللَّهُ لِبَأْسَ الْجُوعِ وَالْخَوْفِ بِمَا كَانُوا يَصْنَعُونَ. Allah tells us about Mecca. Mecca, the rizq was coming to them from where? يَأْتِيهَا رِزْقُهَا رَغَدًا مِنْ كُلِّ مَكَانٍ. The blessing and the rizq was coming to them from every direction. Allah then says, فَكَفَرَتْ. What does فَكَفَرَتْ here mean? It means they did not show what? Shukur. The kufr here means kufr ni'mah. They disbelieved in the blessing. They did not show gratitude, and because the blessing once sent their way, they should have responded to it with what? Gratitude. They didn't do that. They used the body that were given to them, the fingers and the eyes and the mouth and the ears that were given to them. They used it for that which was haram. And so then, is that blessing going to remain? Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, look what he said, فَأَذَاقَهَ اللَّهُ لِبَأْسَ الْجُوعِ وَالْخَوْفِ بِمَا كَانُوا يَصْنَعُونَ. Because of what they did, Allah made the people of Mecca, hunger and poverty and fear came to them. When Allah blesses us, brothers, we should not introduce haram. We should not introduce sins in our lives, because that blessing, the safety that we have, the blessings that we have, the good that we have, Allah will go. Allah says, فَبِمَا نَقْضِهِمْ مِيثَاقَهُمْ لَعَنَّاهُمْ وَجَعَلْنَا قُلُوبَهُمْ قَاسِيَةً. In another ayah, Allah says, إِنَّا بَلَوْنَاهُمْ كَمَا بَلَوْنَا أَصْحَابَ الْجَنَّةِ إِذَا أَقْسَمُوا لَيَسْرِمُنَّهَا مُسْبِحِينَ. You all know the story of the boys who their father left behind a garden for them in Surah Al-Qalam. Allah left for them what? A garden. And Allah, their father was a righteous man. What he used to do was, the garden, when it reached the time to give the zakat from it, he used to follow the ayah, وَآتُوا حَقَّهُ يَوْمَ حَصَادِ. He would give the zakat from it. But then, and he would tell the poor people to come into the garden. And he would say, choose what you want, whatever crops you want, take. And they would do it. But when he died, his children took over, they changed their situation. And they went against the way that their father was. And so what did they do? They told, أَلَّا يَدْخُلَنَّهَا الْيَوْمَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِسْكِينَ. No miskin is going to enter this garden today. We're not going to let none of them enter. Our father was confused. He didn't know what he was doing. We have to look after our property. So we're not going to let no miskin enter. What happened to them? فَطَافَ عَلَيْهَا طَائِفٌ مِّن رَبِّكَ وَهُمْ نَائِمُونَ فَأَصْبَحَتْ كَالسَّرِيمِ فَتَنَادَوْا مُصْبِحِينَ. When they woke up in the morning, they thought they planned everything out. In the morning they were planning to not enter, to not let the poor enter. But little did they know, Allah also planned, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah planned, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah made the whole entire garden, Allah made it sareem, it made into ashes. If you look at the Salaf brothers, whenever they entered onto their wives and their families, if they saw their wife was not obeying them, and if they saw that their family members and everyone was against them, even if their riding beast was not doing as they used to say, إِذَا عَصَيْنَا اللَّهَ, if we disobey Allah, كُنَّا نَرَى أَثَرَ ذَلِكَ, we used to see the effects of our sins and our wives and our children and on our riding beast. Everything doesn't work. But where did they believe that this problem came to them from? That the wife wasn't listening and the children were not listening and the whole family, where did they think it came to them from? Their own sins. Because they believed it came from them. And that's why they are in the situation that they're in. Allah also tells us about the story of لَقَدْ كَانَ لِسَبَئٍ فِي مَسْكَنِهِمْ آيَةٌ جَنَّتَانِ عَنْ يَمِينِ وَشِمَالٍ كُلُوا مِنْ رِزْقِ رَبِّكُمْ وَاشْكُرُوا لَهُ بَلْدَةٌ طَيِّبَةٌ وَرَبٌّ غَفُورٌ فَأَعْرَضُوا فَأَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ سَيْلَ الْعَرِمِ وَبَدَّلْنَاهُمْ بِجَنَّتَيْهِمْ جَنَّتَيْنِ ذَوَاتَيْ أُكُلٍ خَمْطٍ وَأَثْلٍ وَشَيْءٍ مِنْ سِدْرٍ قَلِيلٍ ذَلِكَ جَزَيْنَاهُمْ بِمَا كَفَرُوا وَهَلْ نُجَازِي إِلَّا الْكَفُورَ. Allah mentions many stories like that. إِنَّ قَارُونَ كَانَ مِنْ قَوْمِ مُوسَى فَبَغَى عَلَيْهِمْ وَآتَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْكُنُوزِ مَا إِنَّ مَفَاتِيحَهُ لَتَنُوءُ بِالْعُصْبَةِ أُولِي الْقُوَّةِ. Qarun had money, had everything. But did he obey Allah? Did he go against Allah's command? Allah said, فَخَسَفْنَا بِهِ وَبِدَارِهِ الْأَرْضِ فَمَا كَانَ لَهُ مِنْ فِيَةِ يَنْصُرُونَهُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُتَصِرِ. He had no one to help him. He had no one to aid him. Nobody to support him. Allah, he made the earth swallow him. Qarun. Are we all together, brothers? There is a way that Allah deals with criminals and sinners. And that is, whatever blessing was given to them will be taken away from them when they disobey Allah, when they go against Allah's command. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَبِالْمِرْصَادِ. Indeed, your Lord is observing your actions and everything that you do. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. And wallahi, brothers, nothing is hidden from Him. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَعْلَمُ خَائِنَةَ الْأَعْيُنِ وَمَا تُخْفِي الصُّدُورِ. Allah knows that the person who's trying to deceive the people, and Allah knows what's in the people's chests. He knows what's in the people's hearts. I ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to make us those who are righteous privately and publicly. And may Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala forgive us for any shortcomings or mistakes that we may have come from with. إِنَّهُ وَلِيُّ ذَلِكَ وَالْقَادِرُ عَلَيْهِ. سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ بِحَمْدِكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ.